Hello everyone, I'm Brianna, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm doing another book review video because I really just read this book recently and I loved it so much. And that is Focus by Carla Sorensen. This is book one in her new Ward Sisters series. This is going to be a 4-book series following the four sisters of this story. If you don't know, this is a spin-off series to one of my favorite sports romance series by her, which is The Washington Wolves. The Washington Wolves have three books. All three books can be read as standalones, but I do recommend reading the last book of that series, The Marriage Effect, which I do also have a book review up about that. I recommend reading that before you read Focused, because The Marriage Effect kind of introduces the girls that are going to be the main characters in the Ward Sisters series, and it kind of shows just a family dynamic and what they're about and everything like that. The Marriage Effect also does introduce the two love interests in this book, Molly and Noah, right? Yeah, Molly and Noah. And they kind of show what happened to them when they were younger and their dynamic together before you get into here. So this book takes place when Molly is older. She has a job with the Wolves. I think she's part of the HR department, if I remember correctly, but she has a high up role. And the biggest thing is that her brother did not get her the role here. She got it herself, although she did get recommendations from her brother. Noah is a character that we saw in the last series, and Noah was a younger college football athlete, and he was very, very big defensive player. And obviously Molly was a lot younger back then, so stuff happened in that book. And then in this series, it's them kind of reconnecting, and Molly's trying to do her job and be serious and stay away from Noah. And it's a mix between a hate to love romance and a friends to lovers romance. So it's kind of in the middle, because they kind of hate each other because of everything that happened in the last book, but they also have a deeper connection. So they do like each other. It's like a whole big thing in this book. What I really, really love about this book is, honestly, it is another sports romance, and sports romances are definitely one of my favorite genres ever. But this book also really, truly showed character growth and just characters coming full circle. And to me, what really makes a book is obviously a great plot line, but also the characters. If you don't have entertaining or relatable characters, I can't connect with the book. I also think Carla Sorensen does an amazing job just really having a full plot and kind of being able to show a range of emotions in such a short book, because this book is only about 300 to 400 pages. Oh, it's only 300. So it is a really, really short book. And normally I don't like my romances this short because they don't develop, but Carla Sorensen did such a phenomenal job, honestly. Like, this book, if you have never read Carla Sorensen before or you want to start sports romances, I think this is a great place to start. This book was just really, really good. And I'm trying not to do spoilers because this is a mix. It's a start of a new series, but it does connect with the old series. But yeah, if you guys are really interested in reading this, I definitely recommend checking it out. The next book, Faked, is going to be about Molly's younger twin sister. And that one, although it's not a sports romance, it's going to have sport athletes in it, because that is what these series kind of encompass. And it's about twin sister swaps, and I think those books are really funny to read and to get engaged with. But that book is coming out the middle of June, I think June 16th. This book was released in January. I just only received it now because I didn't know it was released. But yeah, I definitely recommend diving into these. I think these are great feel-good books for the summer. They're not too long, and they're just like really funny, but they do have some emotion to them. So I really recommend these books. Now I'm going to get into the spoiler section a little bit, because I want to kind of do a deeper discussion of the characters. I recommend not watching this if you haven't read the book. If you want to watch it, go right on ahead, but it may include some spoiler details. Okay, hi spoiler people. So honestly, I really, really love Molly in this book. I hated her in the first book. in The Marriage Effect. That book follows Logan, which is her older brother and her guardian in that series. It follows his romance, and Molly's 16. And in that book, you kind of see the dynamic between her and Noah. She's a younger girl, she's starting to like boys, and she's kind of trying to do typical displays that girls do, like tan in the backyard and try and get his attention. But obviously, he's a college athlete, doesn't really care about anything but football. I just liked how we could see growth from 16-year-old Molly all the way now. I think this is 5 years later, so mid-20s. I can't do math, but I think she's in her mid-20s. You can see how professional she is, but she's also kind of quirky. She hates high heels, so she wears kind of these soft loafer shoes to work, but she's really great at her job. I also like how a lot of the references in here were very relevant. They talk about the Amazon documentary series that they do with different football teams now. I forgot the exact documentary, but I know I've watched the Panthers season. But I thought that was really cool. You also get to see the dynamic of Noah, how he kind of really changed. He was more of like a shy, but a little like cocky kid when he was younger. And now he's just like shy. Everything's about football. He doesn't have friends. I do wish he could have been a little closer to his teammates. And again, obviously in my books, I always want a little more of the sports aspect. But this book was solely more about the characters and their development. But I really, really liked Noah, and I liked how he wasn't pushy, and he kind of was learning his feelings as well as Molly was. So it was very back and forth, and I liked how true it felt to, like, an actual real romance. But yeah, I also really enjoy just the cute aspects, like Logan still being really protective of Molly. Molly still was really close with her sister. She shared an apartment with Isabel, and the twins would come over. They would do family lunch, and then you get to see also more dynamics with Logan has a son, so all of that. But I really, really recommend reading this book. I think this is a great summer read. You have three books before this to kind of get involved in the series, and then you have one coming out soon. But I recommend this if you are interested in a sports romance. This is a great start for you. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope you guys are gonna give this book a try. I'll link the Amazon link to this book, which is where I purchased it. So I hope you guys enjoy this. Bye.